Imagine a place where lightning strikes almost continuously, illuminating the night sky with a spectacle of radiant flashes. This is not a scene from a science fiction movie, but a real and enduring phenomenon known as the Catatumbo lightning. This captivating spectacle happens in the northern part of Venezuela, where the Catatumbo River meets Lake Maracaibo. Here, one can witness a phenomenon that seems to defy the transient nature of storms. The Catatumbo lightning, as it's known, doesn't just flash and fade away. Instead, it puts on a ceaseless show of electrical discharge that brightens the night sky with an awe-inspiring dance of light. The frequency and intensity of this phenomenon are mind-boggling. It doesn't occur once or twice a year, but up to 150 times. Yes, you heard it right. The Catatumbo lightning can grace the sky up to 150 times a year. But that's not all. These are not fleeting storms that are here one moment and gone the next. These storms can last up to 9 hours a day, with a staggering 28 lightning strikes per minute. In Venezuela, the Catatumbo lightning has earned itself quite a few nicknames. Some call it the everlasting storm, a testament to its ceaseless display of electrical power. Others refer to it as the Maracaibo beacon, a nod to its function as a lighthouse of sorts for ships navigating the waters of Lake Maracaibo. But regardless of what you call it, the Catatumbo lightning is a phenomenon that captivates all who witness it. It's a demonstration of nature's incredible power, a spectacle that leaves you in awe of the world's wonders. The Catatumbo lightning, a seemingly endless electrical ballet, paints a picture of a world where nature's theatrics take center stage. No matter where you're from or what you believe, it's hard to deny the sheer magic of this eternal storm. And in the end, isn't that what makes life so fascinating? The ability to witness such breathtaking displays of nature's power, beauty, and mystery. The Catatumbo lightning, while a visual spectacle, is also a subject of scientific intrigue. This unique meteorological phenomenon has had scientists scratching their heads for centuries, attempting to decipher its many secrets. So, what causes the Catatumbo lightning? Well, it's a question with no definite answer, but many intriguing theories. One of the most popular theories is the mixing of warm and cold air currents. You see, the area where the Catatumbo River meets Lake Maracaibo is a hotspot for climatic clashes. Warm air from the Caribbean Sea meets with cooler Andean air, causing an atmospheric tension that results in frequent and intense lightning storms. But the story doesn't end there. Another factor that might play a significant role in the formation of the Catatumbo lightning is the presence of methane. The region is not only home to large bodies of water, but also abundant oil deposits and marshes. These areas emit methane, a potent greenhouse gas, into the atmosphere. Some researchers speculate that this methane may contribute to the formation of the Catatumbo lightning. The gas, when mixed with stormy conditions, could help create the perfect environment for sparking these nocturnal sky shows. Despite these theories, the precise cause of the Catatumbo lightning remains a mystery. Some believe it's a combination of both the clashing air currents and methane emissions, while others think there might be other factors at play. These could include the region's unique topography, or even the electrical characteristics of the local atmosphere. While the exact cause remains a subject of debate, the Catatumbo lightning stands as a testament to the complex and captivating phenomena of our natural world. It's a reminder that there are still mysteries out there, waiting for us to unravel them, and that the pursuit of understanding is a journey filled with flashes of insight and sparks of discovery. Is the Catatumbo lightning truly an eternal storm? The answer may surprise you. This dazzling phenomenon, often referred to as the eternal storm, has been known to cease. In fact, during the first 4 months of 2010, the lightning activity came to a complete halt. This pause in the performance was likely due to a regional drought that had gripped the area. The sky was quiet, the usual orchestra of light and sound silenced. This period of tranquility challenged the myth of the storm's endlessness, proving that even the most persistent of spectacles can take a curtain call. Yet the Catatumbo lightning is not entirely unpredictable. Although it does not follow a strict timetable, there is a certain rhythm to its performances. The storm doesn't start at the same time every day. On some days, it might begin in the early evening, while on others, it may hold off until after midnight. The most spectacular display, however, always happens under the cover of night, when the darkness serves as a canvas for the lightning's dramatic dance. There's a variability in the storm's start times and peak activity, which adds an element of suspense for those fortunate enough to witness this natural marvel. This variability is likely due to a complex interplay of local weather patterns, atmospheric conditions, and perhaps even the influence of distant weather phenomena. So, if you're planning to visit this region to witness the Catatumbo lightning, bear in mind that patience will be your best companion. The storm, while not punctual, is worth waiting for. Its unpredictability is part of its charm. The Catatumbo lightning, while not truly eternal, still presents a spectacle of such regularity and intensity that it continues to captivate those who witness it. Its ceaseless flashes, although not truly endless, create a performance of such magnificence that it leaves an indelible impression on all who have the chance to see it. Whether it's the middle of the night or the early hours of dawn, the Catatumbo lightning remains a spectacular sight to behold. The allure of the Catatumbo lightning extends beyond the scientific world, permeating popular culture and literature. The unending flashes of light, the thunderous sounds, and the mystique of this natural phenomenon have not only sparked scientific curiosity, but also ignited the creative flames of authors, poets, and storytellers for centuries. One of the earliest known references to the Catatumbo lightning is found in the realm of Spanish literature. In the late 16th century, the renowned Spanish poet Lope de Vega used this relentless storm as a backdrop in his epic war poem, La Dragontea. Vega's vivid depiction of the storm in his verses captured the awe-inspiring and fearsome nature of the Catatumbo lightning, etching it into the annals of literary history. But the influence of Catatumbo lightning doesn't stop at literature. It has also found its way into the world of modern pop culture. The storm's enigmatic nature has inspired numerous works of fiction, from novels to movies, and even video games, where it's often used to create an environment of suspense and thrill. It's not uncommon to see characters in these narratives braving the elements, with the unyielding flashes of the Catatumbo lightning illuminating their paths. Notably, the Catatumbo lightning has made its mark on music as well. Various musicians have been inspired by its eternal flashes, composing songs that capture the storm's relentless energy and its rhythmic dance of light and sound. In all these instances, the Catatumbo lightning serves as a symbol of nature's grandeur, a testament to its unpredictability, and a reminder of its raw, untamed power. It's a phenomenon that continues to inspire, fascinate, and captivate, weaving its way into our stories, songs, and imaginations. Whether it's in the realm of science or culture, the Catatumbo lightning continues to spark fascination, illuminating our understanding of the world's natural wonders. The tale of the Catatumbo lightning is one of awe, fascination, and scientific intrigue. This phenomenon, known as the Beacon of Maracaibo, is not just a captivating spectacle. It is a testament to the enduring mysteries of nature and the elements that shape our world. Let's take a moment to revisit the key points of our discussion. The Catatumbo lightning, occurring over the Catatumbo River in Venezuela, is a remarkable atmospheric phenomenon that has been observed for centuries. Its frequency is staggering, with storms occurring upwards of 150 times a year, sometimes lasting up to 9 hours a day, and producing an astonishing 28 lightning strikes per minute. The cause of these electric extravaganzas remains a subject of scientific investigation. The most prevalent theory points to the unique interplay of cold and warm air currents in the region, coupled with the significant methane emissions from the area's oil fields and marshes. However, the true cause remains shrouded in scientific mystery, making the Catatumbo lightning a fascinating subject for ongoing research. While the Catatumbo lightning is often referred to as the endless storm, it is not, in fact, continuous. The lightning's activity can vary, and there have been periods of complete cessation, such as during the first 4 months of 2010, likely due to a regional drought. The Catatumbo lightning has also made a significant impact on culture, featuring in literature since the late 16th century. Its awe-inspiring spectacle has captured imaginations, inspiring stories, and fostering a sense of wonder. Whether it's the dazzling light show it provides or the questions it poses for scientific exploration, the Catatumbo Lightning continues to be a beacon of wonder in our world.